All right, welcome back. Let's see if you got it right. So to recap here, we have a return air of 75 degrees, refrigerant temperature of 40 degrees. You were to check your PT chart for R22 to find out what pressure corresponds to 40 degrees Fahrenheit and what is the TD. Let's see if you got things right. So the R22 pressure that corresponds to 40 degrees is 68.5 PSIG or 60 PSIG. The delta T is the return air temperature less the refrigerant temperature, which is gives us a 35 degree TD in this example. So what you should have done, if you didn't do it, as we'll review our pressure temperature chart, is what is the pressure temperature relationship for R22 at 68 PSIG. And so what you do is you go down to your PSIG column down to 68 and you read it over to the R22 column. So at 68 PSIG we have a 40 degree pressure temperature relationship. So what is the evaporator temperature if the suction pressure is 62 PSIG on a 404A system? I'll give you a minute here to find it. All right, so 62 PSIG pressure corresponds to 25 degree Fahrenheit in a 404A system. And one last one, 404A at 50 PSIG. What is the temperature of the refrigerant for your delta T, not your delta T, your TD calculation? Your TD calculation for this example, you would use 16 degrees Fahrenheit. All right, so if you're not familiar with your PT chart, you need to become familiar. The reason being is there are so many different kinds of refrigerants, you may not have that scale on your gauges. All right, so you read your suction pressure with your low side gauge, and then you can read the suction temperature off of your gauge if you have the right type of gauges. So let's look at an R22 system with a low side gauge hooked up. We have 69, 68.5 PSIG on our pressure scale, and the corresponding R22 temperature, saturation temperature, is 40 degrees. And here we have a 49 PSIG temperature on the low side gauge, and then your corresponding coil temperature is 25 degrees using your R22 scale. Now, the one good thing about you having a PT chart or having a PT app on your phone is if you have a set of gauges and you are on a system that has a refrigerant that is not listed on your gauge, you can take your pressure from your low side gauge and use your app or your PT chart to calculate the corresponding temperature. So make sure you know how to do that and you always have a PT chart or app with you at all times. All right, so that's the end of the lesson. The thing you need to take away from this is to check a system in a commercial refrigeration to check if everything is operating as it should be. You use TD, the temperature difference, and that's the difference between the air entering the evaporator and the pressure temperature of the refrigerant in the evaporator coil.